I think this is a campaign, this is a part of campaign, not against Major General Doron Almog, but against the State of Israel. And the State of Israel and the legitimacy of the Israeli legal system all over. So, with all my respect to you, I think a part of the discussion is about should we continue dealing and discussing in London a case that the State of Israel needs to discuss and of course need to be controlled by the international system and then the international society. This is fine, but it's a case that the State of Israel need to continue dealing inside, and I don't see a reason to deal on the principal level, to deal and in London, in this case specifically. It's a campaign against the state of Israel, and I think we need to block this lacuna and to improve the international law in this period. In this period, we continue fighting against radical, ultra-radical, ultra-Islamic, even in London. You remember, no need to tell you about July 7, 2005, the bombing inside London, and we, the westernized country, continue fighting against Islamists and extreme Islamism, and I think the international law was founded mainly for two conditions, a peace and a wartime. And when I say a wartime, it's not the war on terrorism. A wartime, it's a full-scale war, like Second World War, or like our 67 war, armies against armies, nations against nations. But when a nation fighting against bin Laden cells all over, all of a sudden without any declaration, in September 11, some assets of America were attacked. All of a sudden, no one declared a war. But what is it? What I'm saying right now, we need to elaborate, we need to improve the international law and to block lacunas and better protect ourselves and find a proportion on who is justified and who is right and who is wrong in this campaign against extremism. For instance, just let you know, I mentioned the 145 suicide bombers attacked Israel and killed more than 1,000 Israelis. Is there even one lawsuit? One lawsuit, one arrest warrant against people behind that killed innocents in Israel, at the State of Israel, at the heartland of Israel. There is no, I don't know about even one arrest warrant against the people behind, the Islamists, the leaders of the jihad and the radical Islam, that under their order, innocent people were killed in Israel. No, even I don't know, even one case that they were accused and were called to international justice.